हेलो एवरीवन, आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू आर हैविंग अ ग्रेट टाइम एंड वी आर जस्ट 1 week अवे फ्रॉम कंप्लीटिंग द सेप्टेम्बर लीडकोड चैलेंज. दिस विल बी द 13th मंथ इन द रो ऑफ डूइंग लीडकोड चैलेंजेस एंड आई वुड लाइक टू थैंक यू ऑल फॉर द कंसिस्टेंसी एंड आई वुड रिक्वेस्ट यू टू पैट योर सेल्फ ऑन द बैक फॉर दिस ग्रेट अचीवमेंट. वी हैव बीन इम्प्रूविंग सो फार एंड यू गाइज मस्ट हैव बीन गेटिंग कॉन्फिडेंस about performing better in the interviews as well. Without much ado, let's look at today's question. The question says, break a palindrome. Here we are given a string that is palindromic in nature. We are allowed to replace exactly one character from this string such that the string becomes non-palindromic in nature, and the character that we are replacing should be such that the newly generated string is lexicographically smallest as possible. Let's try and understand it by an example. Here we are given the palindromic string as ABCCBA. Now we replace this, the first B with an A, and the updated string is something like this, AACCBA. This is non-palindromic in nature and this is the lexicographically smallest string after the breakage. Let's now move on to the PPT. I'll explain the example as well as the way to build the algorithm in that section. Break a palindrome, LeetCode 1328. It's a medium level question on LeetCode and I also feel the same. It's just that you need to think of couple of test cases before finally concluding the algorithm. So let's walk through one of the possible case. Here I have taken a slightly different example so as to cover a wide range of test cases. The first example says the input string is something like this, X A B Y B A X. It is palindromic in nature. Now we want to break this string into a non-palindromic one, and we can only replace one character out of the complete string. Also, it should give us the lexicographically smallest possible non-palindromic string. So how are we going to start the iteration? The first character that we see is X. Since it's X, we can simply go and replace this X with an A, because A is lexicographically smallest character of English alphabets. And let's see what happened. The updated string is AABYBAX. Awesome. It is lexicographically smallest and it is non-palindromic in nature. Both the constraints are fulfilled. Let's move on to the next string. Here we are given ABBYBBA. You can see this is again palindromic in nature. And let's start the iteration. We see an A here. Since it's already an A, we can't replace, it doesn't make sense to replace it again by an A. So what do we do? Let's move on to the next character. Here we see a B. So as soon as you see a B, what you can do, you can simply update this B to an A. And once we have updated this, what is the updated string? It's AABYBBA. Pretty straightforward, is it? It is lexicographically smallest and non-palindromic in nature. Let's move ahead. Next we see is AABYBAA. Let's start the iteration. We see an A, can't do anything. Let's move ahead. We see another A, can't do anything. Next we see is B. What do? We replace B by an A. And what is the updated string? AAAYBAA. Again, this is lexicographically smallest and non-palindromic in nature. Both the constraints are fulfilled. We got the updated string. Let's move ahead to the next iteration. And this is genuinely a different case. Let's see how it works. We have AAA. We have Y followed by 3 A's. And it is a palindromic string. So we start the iteration. We see an A. We again see an A. We again see an A. And next we see a Y here. So what do? Replace this by A? No. This time, even if we do that, it will not lead to a non-palindromic string and I will not get the answer. Why? What is so special at this particular index? We need to carefully observe it. So let me just write the indexes once more. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. If you go and carefully observe, this is a middle point of the palindromic string. एंड वी ऑल्सो नो दैट दिस पॉइंट इज अ पॉइंट ऑफ रिफ्लेक्शन. दिस पार्ट ऑफ द स्ट्रिंग विल बी इक्वल टू दिस पार्ट ऑफ द स्ट्रिंग. सो लेट मी जस्ट ड्रॉ एरोस. दिस कैरेक्टर वुड बी इक्वल टू दिस, दिस कैरेक्टर वुड बी इक्वल टू दिस कैरेक्टर वुड बी इक्वल टू दिस कैरेक्टर. एंड वी हैव ट्रेवर्स्ड द हाफ पार्ट, वी आर एट द मिडल पॉइंट एंड वी डोंट सी एन ए. दैट मीन्स ऑन इट्स रिफ्लेक्शन पार्ट ऑल द एलिमेंट्स दैट आर देयर आर ऑल्सो एज इन नेचर. सो वॉट डू वी डू इन दिस केस? एज सून एज वी रीच द मिडल पॉइंट वी गो एंड अपडेट द लास्ट कैरेक्टर ऑफ द स्ट्रिंग विद अ बी. सो इफ वी डू दिस विल वी गेट अ नॉन पैलिंड्रोमिक स्ट्रिंग विच इज लेक्सोग्राफिकली लीस्ट इन नेचर. येस, लेट्स राइट द स्ट्रिंग अप. वी हैव ए ए ए वाई ए ए बी. ऑल्सो रिप्लेसिंग दिस वाई स्ट्रिंग बाई एनी कैरेक्टर विल नॉट डू एनी गुड टू अस. इट्स ऑफ नो यूज बिकॉज इट्स एन ऑड लेंथ पैलेंड्रोमिक स्ट्रिंग एंड इट कैन बी एनी कैरेक्टर. सो इट डजेंट मेक सेंस टू रिप्लेस दिस बाई एनी कैरेक्टर एनी अदर कैरेक्टर बिकॉज इट इज एन ऑड लेंथ पैलेंड्रोमिक स्ट्रिंग. देयरफॉर वी अपडेट द लास्ट कैरेक्टर ऑफ द स्ट्रिंग बाई वी वेन एवर वी रीच द मिडल पॉइंट ऑफ द पैलेंड्रोमिक स्ट्रिंग. आई थिंक आई शुड हैव एक्सप्लेन्ड द इवन लेंथ पैलेंड्रोमिक स्ट्रिंग फर्स्ट एंड देन द ऑड लेंथ, बट इट्स ओके. लेट्स लुक एट द इवन लेंथ पैलेंड्रोमिक स्ट्रिंग. वी हैव ए ए ए ए ए ए एंड लेट्स स्टार्ट द इटरेशन. वी सी एन ए, कांट डू एनीथिंग. वी अगेन सी एन ए, कांट डू एनीथिंग. वी अगेन सी एन ए, कांट डू एनीथिंग. एंड नाउ वी हैव रीच द मिडल पॉइंट. And so what do? In those cases, we know that since we have reached the middle point, the left part of the string will contain all A's, so does the right part. And we simply go and update the last character by B. So this is the updated string, triple A, double B, double A followed by B. And this is what we are gonna code it up. So without much ado, let's look at the coding section. We convert the palindromic string into the character array using two char helper method. We go and check if my string length is less than 2, that means there is only one string or empty. We simply return empty because there is no way you can make a string with single character non-palindromic in nature. Next we go ahead and start the iteration up till half of the length. We go and check if my current character happens to be A. If it is the case, then we can't do anything. If it is not an A, we update the character to an A and we return the updated string. Otherwise, once you are out of the loop, it simply means you have crossed the half length or the middle, you are at the middle point. You simply go and update the last character of the string with B because all the elements that are there in the string till the middle point are A's. And in the end, you simply return the updated char set, the string value of it. Let's go and submit it. Accepted. The time complexity of this approach is length of the input string that has given to us. And this brings me to the end of today's session. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to the channel. Thanks for viewing it. Have a great day ahead. And stay tuned for more updates from Coding Decoded. I'll see you tomorrow with another fresh question. And I would recommend you guys to watch the Million Dollar Advice video if you have not already watched that in the past. Go and check that out. It's worth watching.